the multidimensional poverty index and its impact. During the third administration of President Sebastián Piñera, in the context of a broad discussion on the existing methodology, tools, and institutional arrangements of income poverty measurement, the government created a presidential commission to measure poverty, whose main function was to advise on the review of all elements related to defining new moderate and extreme poverty lines. This commission set forth proposals for updating methodology for measuring income poverty, as well as for adopting a multidimensional approach. The formulations by this commission were analyzed and evaluated by the Interinstitutional Technical Panel during President Mitzvah-Telet's second administration. This is between the years 2014 and 2018. In an effort to led by this ministry, the Ministry of Social Development and the National Institute of Statistics, with expert advising from the Economic Commission for Latin America and the Caribbean and the Oxford Poverty and Human Development Initiative of the University of Oxford. In addition, to support the work of the ITP, this Interinstitutional Technical Panel, the ministry enlisted the participation of ministries and public services of the government, encouraging that dialogue and the joint exploration of possible dimensions, indicators, and thresholds to consider while building a multidimensional poverty index for children. The proposal took into consideration a collection of specific indicators at describing the fifth dimensions called local environment and networks, using the questions included for the first time in the National Socioeconomic Characterization Survey, in Chile we call that Survey CASEN, from 2013. In this proposal, local environment was understood as the collection of conditions that characterize the territory, the surroundings, and the characteristics of habitat or places where people live. And networks were the social capital available to individuals and households, including their connections and mechanisms for social interaction that facilitate care for the family, cooperation, mutual support, and access to material, cultural, and financial resources, which facilitate the achievement of personal and collective goals. This is a quote from the report that this commission made. The indicators within this proposal were evaluated from different aspects, first conceptual and methodological point of view by this ITP, this interdimensional technical panel, and obviously also from a statistical point of view by the Ministry of Social Development after the data of CASEN 2013 was released. The evaluation of the results obtained from the local environment and network indicators proposed by the Commission, while constituting an expansion in the scope of observation of the phenomenon of poverty in our country from a multidimensional perspective, reveal the kind of problems at different levels. These problems emerged in elements such as their conceptual definition, design and operationalization in the CASEN survey, and the accuracy of the estimates that were generated. Because of this, it was considered prudent to exclude the local environment and networks dimension in the first version of the National Multidimensional Poverty Index in order to continue discussing and evaluating the alternatives of new indicators. Therefore, in 2015, the Chilean government introduced an official multidimensional poverty measure using data from 2013 in which four dimensions were considered: education, health, employment and social security, and housing. The first version of the MPI took into account the remaining four dimensions. Each dimension had three indicators, each one equally weighted at 8.3%, identifying a household as multidimensional poor if it was experiencing 25% of the weight deprivations or more. After evaluating all the situation and the resulting analysis, Chile took the challenge of expanding the measures to another dimension, not only the first exercise that we made as a country to have a multidimensional poverty index. So also to include in this idea of the multidimensional poverty index the measurement of the family well-being, taking into account the relevance of the local environment and support networks to a household level of well-being. The decision to delay the inclusion of these elements in the MPI or a multidimensional poverty index so to ensure that the questions and the data that we will be using in this index would better reflect these problems, thus preserving the validity and consensus reached with the initial multidimensional measure. Therefore, in 2015, the Ministry Advisory Committee on the Local Environment and Web and Networks was set up. We put into work a committee that was specifically analyzing this issue of how to include networks and local environment as a measure of multidimensional poverty index. It was made up by academics and representatives of the civil society organization with the goal of supporting the evaluation process for the incorporating these areas in our MPI. The same that we do, we did for the first process of the multidimensional poverty index to have an advisory for the committee. We now, the ministry, build this committee to own specifically analyze the idea of including the idea of family well-being and specifically in networks and specifically also in local environment to have these ideas included also in our multidimensional poverty index. Including this deprivations in the measurement of poverty means that there are now indicators that can be integrated into the current measure of multidimensional poverty, adhering to the rigorous standards of statistical validation. Before that can happen, it's essential to reach consensus on the use of these indicators to undefined regulatory thresholds that are consistent with existing public policy framework as well as with the current expectations and demands of the population and with the commitments made by the international community. At the advisory committee's suggestion, this process was informed by contributions from an interactive workshop organized by the ministry, resulting in evaluations from civil society regarding multidimensional poverty or measurements of poverty, and specifically regarding the possible incorporation of indicators that measure deprivations associated with their local environment and the social networks available to households. The Committee for Local Environment and Networks deliberate proposals and recommendations that led to the development of new questions that were evaluated in field experiments carried out with between November of 2015 and January of 2016, and subsequently included in the final questionnaire of the 2015 CASEN survey. Based mainly on these questions, the committee proposed that indicators and thresholds be created to evaluate their incorporation into revised in a revised version of our MPI or multidimensional poverty index for our country. As with this previous process, the evaluation of this proposal and the creation and validation of a new measure of multidimensional poverty had the ongoing support of the Oxford Poverty Household Initiative. In addition, there was feedback from ministries and public services. Contributions by the previous commission, the ITP, CEPAL comments and advising from another panel of experts convened also with the CASEN 2015 survey. Why do we believe that we are sure that incorporating local environment and networks indicator is relevant in the MPI index? We have several reasons about that that we're going to review now. First of all, the physical, social, environmental, and security conditions of the place where people live, as well as the lack of networks that provide support, protection, care, and access to resources in the face of emergency situations, create powerful limitations that not only make overcoming poverty more challenging, but also are a form of social exclusion. That's the first reason, and that's why we need to measure this in a multidimensional poverty index. Another reason is in the realm of local environment, the notion of well-being is heavily influenced by the experience of inhabiting a specific area. The local environment includes geographic barriers, for example, distance, travel time, accessibility to other places, and availability of transport, and also risks to physical and mental health from exposure to sources of contamination, lack of green and wooded areas,
as well as the effect of other external conditions in the surroundings, and also limitations on the development of activities conducted to a recreational, leisure, and social and cultural life. That's all that lacks make poverty also a more difficult barrier to overcome. Also, another reason is that studies of poverty, social capital, and social network has been recognized as central elements, both with regards to its diagnosis, as well as in policies aimed at overcoming poverty. It is known that social capital can set other kinds of resources in motion, allowing those who use it to have access to better life conditions. Also, another reason is that OFI, the Oxford Poverty Household Initiative, has highlighted the importance of considering dimensions such as social isolation as relevant factors in understanding multidimensional poverty. And finally, attention is paid to how social networks interact with mechanisms of segregation, violence, discrimination, and the deterioration of harmony at the local level. All of these elements are related to a broader concept of social cohesion, a fundamental concept in a country that faces high levels of inequality like Chile has. How do we incorporate these fifth dimensions? First of all, it's very important to say that we need validation. You need a support of the society and also all the actors that are involved in the idea of having this multidimensional poverty index. Validation from a public policy standpoint of the dimensions and indicators within a multidimensional poverty measure and acceptable quality standards of data obtained for measuring them are certainly key elements to be safeguarded in this process. And that's what we do as having commissions and also technical support and also the other services from the state and civil society that we made them all part of this process of having a multidimensional index in Chile. In addition, the incorporation of local environment and networks not only meant conceptualizing and implementing the indicators, but also taking into consideration how their addition will work with the first version of the MPI index in Chile. Along this line, the process to incorporate these elements was guided with the following principles. Four of them were the principles that we consider as a ministry to incorporate this fifth dimension. Consistency with the goal of measuring multidimensional poverty, relevance from a public policy perspective, consistency with the first version of our MPI, and also stability of the measure. It is to have continuity in this tool to guide the decisions of public policy in our country. In conjunction with the above, statistical trials and analysis were carried out as a foundation for the creation of a revised measure for multidimensional poverty, using only the information available before the creation of the 2015 CASEN survey database. In doing so, an attempt was made to ensure that the methodology used to measure multidimensional poverty was based exclusively on technically and regulatory reasons, without taking into account the effects that would be observable in the results, the percentage of households and population in situation of poverty. Our revised version of the MPI for Chile, this version with five dimensions, which incorporates local environment and network, was formulated taking into account, in summary, not only the Ministerial Advisory Committee and the local environment network's conceptual and operational definition, principle and statistic, but also contributions for the public institutions, other actors, and all of them that have a little participation or big participation in the decision of public policy design and implementation in our country. Among the main changes to the measure of multidimensional poverty are the following. Five dimensions relevant to the well-being of households and their members: education, health, employment and social security, housing and environment, and network and social cohesion. Each dimension includes an equal number of indicators, three deprivations, in order to ensure consistency with the current measures and give equal weight to each indicator within each dimension. The housing dimension is expanding to incorporate the concept of housing and environment, which include three indicators: habitability, which includes deprivations of overcrowding and housing conditions, basic services, and environment. This new conceptualization of the housing dimension addresses deprivation linked to the accessibility of social services and facilities. A fifth dimension is added: networks and social cohesion, made up of three indications of deprivation in households: social support and participation, physical safety, and discrimination. The four dimensions that were originally included in the measure are given equal weight to 22.5%. Meanwhile, the networks and social cohesion dimension is weighed at 10%. This difference between the consideration given to the original dimensions and the new dimension, 22.5% versus 10%, favors the stability of the measure, as it reduced the likelihood that households and persons identified as multidimensional poor will fail to be considered as being in poverty as a result of incorporating the new indicators. Likewise, the weights of the indicators of each dimension are equal, which means that they are weighed at 7.5% in the case of the original dimensions: health, education, employment and social security, and housing and environment, and 3.33% for the indicators of the networks and social cohesion dimension. In this new context, a household is considered to be in a situation of multidimensional poverty if it is deprived in the equivalent of one of the four original dimensions, that is, if it accumulates 22.5% of weight deprivations or more. Conclusion: the incorporation of missing dimensions such as local environment and networks to the multidimensional poverty index in Chile resulted in a series of challenges. As with the other dimensions, we need obviously rigorous conceptualization and operationalization of the new indicators. Nonetheless, in this case, the challenge was of a greater magnitude, considering that obtaining information through the use of household surveys resulted in a very limited report. Given this fact, establishing a consensus among different stakeholders in society is key to validate and support the measure from a public policy perspective, as well as responding effectively to the demands of the population. This process has also underscores that, while there is a previous version of the measure, the expanded MPI for Chile was intended to remain consistent in its conceptual structure and maintain the continuity of analysis of deprivation in households. Chile, the experience of our country demonstrates that it is possible to overcome those challenges, expanding the group of deprivations without losing continuity with the first version of the measurement of multidimensional poverty as a complement of having the index of poverty in terms of income. We obviously have steps looking forward. First of all, continue strengthening and the measurement, seeking to account for the most relevant deprivations of the population, and finally, continue strengthening the use of the multidimensional poverty measurement in the design of evaluation and public policy. Thank you very much.